Hello friends, welcome to this new video in which I will introduce the custom GPT I created and I called it the Supply Chain Analyst. The idea is to create a GPT with several modules including analytics products that I shared in my articles. You can find the link in the description and the comment section. This GPT will automate the analysis of your sales and categorize your items with a comprehensive study of the rotation of your products using a Pareto chart and data-driven observations to answer questions like how much sales represent the top 20% of my portfolio and a complete categorization of your items in classes A, B, and C, with a visual to link the turnover and the demand variability. Let's move now to the demonstration. You can start by asking to the agent what to do by clicking on this button, how can I start? The agent will load a visual that I designed showing all the different steps. The first step is the data upload. User can decide to use the sample file already loaded in the agent or upload their own dataset. If they decide to use their own dataset, they need to follow the guidelines of the agent. We have a specific template to respect. This template includes 5 columns: the SKU ID, the family, the day of the sales transaction, the quantity, and the turnover. At the end of the prompt, the agent is proposing to use the sample dataset or to upload data. Here, we'll use the sample dataset. And now, the users have to select which metric to use for the analysis. Indeed, if you want to create your Pareto chart or your ABC analysis, you can choose between the quantity and the turnover. For the demonstration here, I will use the quantity. Now that the agent has the dataset and the metric, it can start the analysis using the core model in the Python script that I designed. Initial output is basically comprehensive analysis of your portfolio using a template that I designed and shared with the agent. The idea is to make sure that from one analysis to another, all users have at least the minimum set of parameters needed to understand their product portfolio. As you can see, the agent may add some additional comments, but the core metrics are here. At the end, it will propose you to perform a Pareto analysis or build an ABC chart. Let's ask him to do the Pareto analysis. So now the agent is using the output of the Python script, which is basically a pandas data frame, to create a Pareto chart. In the initial output, there are also additional parameters that can be used for the visuals. But here, as you can see, he has built a Pareto chart. Below the chart, the agent is also adding some additional comments and analysis that can be used to report to your management or take some strategic decisions. Now let's see if we ask him an ABC chart. Same as before, he will use the output of the Python script, including in the core model, to build an ABC chart. Here, I wanted to make sure that the format of the ABC chart is consistent from one user to another, so I gave him some guidelines. First, I asked him to plot a scatter plot. I fixed the x-axis and the y-axis. I fixed the color coding, and I also asked him to add an horizontal line, basically at the coefficient of variation equals to 1, to make the difference between the stable and unstable SKUs, and also 2 vertical lines to separate C, B, and A classes. And you can see below there are additional comments that are generated by the agent. We can ask him to write an email summarizing the results. The idea here is to use the output of the core model and the capabilities of the large language model to automate the reporting task. And as you can see, he's using a professional tone to write to your manager. Here you have manager's name because we didn't specify the name, but you can specify it in the prompt. And he's using the output of the analysis. Now you can ask anything to the agent. He will use the output that are stored in the local variables as I asked him in the initial prompt. He will use the capabilities of GPT to answer your questions. Now the objective for me is to share this GPT to many supply chain professionals and see what are the limits, how can we improve it, so we can use it as a proof of concept to build other modules to have a kind of a complete supply chain analyst. Before concluding this video, let me share with you the architecture I used to build this GPT. The architecture is quite simple. We have an instruction prompt to explain how to use the script, the dataset, and how to interact with users. Users can ask how to start. The agent will explain the process. The core model is a Python script I developed to process data and populate the key metrics. I also uploaded a sample dataset in case users do not have data. Users provide a dataset and set the metric. The agent shows an initial output. This output can be used by the agent to answer advanced requests. If you want to know more about the design, have a look at the article linked in the description.